Hi friends, before going to start my session, I wanted to tell that if you are a teacher on that time, share this video with your students. If you are a student on that time, share with your friends. It is more helpful to them. Now I wanted to say that if you wanted the explanation in other languages, you can tell in the comment box. Now let's begin History Class 9 Chapter 2. Medieval India and Political Transition. In this chapter, we have studies about Rajput dynasties and arrival of Turks in our India. After that, we have studies about Delhi Sultanate. In Delhi Sultanate, we have studies about Ghulam dynasty. After that, we have studied Khilji dynasty. After that, now in today's session, let us see Tughlaq dynasty. Delhi Sultanate, we see some dynasties are there. First one is Ghulam dynasty, Ghulam or slave dynasty. Second one is Khilji dynasty. Third one is Tughlaq dynasty. Fourth one is Sayyid dynasty. And fifth one is Lodi dynasty. Those are all dynasties which are ruled in the area of our India. In today's session, now let's see Tughlaq dynasty. Tughlaq dynasty's rule was started from 1320 to 1399 CE. The Tughlaq dynasty's founder was Ghayasuddin Tughlaq. Ghayasuddin Tughlaq maintained his administration in very peaceful manner in Delhi and implementing liberal administration and some policies related to their own administrative system. He strengthened the border to prevent Mongol invasion. He was protected their area with the border of He protected their own area with the border to prevent the Mongol invasions. He built irrigation canal for the benefit of farmers and lower of and lowered the taxes. First, we see that he has given importance to the agriculture. On the basis, we tell that he has built many canals for the benefit of farmers. On this area, we see that he took lowered taxes. He established the postal system and consisting of horsemen and runners. He was Ghayasuddin Tughlaq was established the system of post and he as a horsemen and runners. They are sent message from one place to another place. He built Tughlaqabad fort near Delhi. His construction was Tughlaqabad fort near Delhi. He conquered Madurai Warangal and some other areas of Gujarat and Bengal. The other important ruler of this dynasty are Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Feroz Tughlaq. In this area we see that some prominent rulers are there. Those are the Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Feroz Tughlaq. Now let's move on towards our another important king was Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He was a scholar of Persian and Arabic language. He was a scholar of Persian and Arabic language. And he was expert in mathematics, physics, medicine and Persian poetry and astronomy and other subjects. He was a great scholar of Persian and Arabic languages. After that, we see he was a good mathematician and he was good in physics, medicine, Persian poetry, astronomy and other subjects also. Though he was a man of knowledge and he had a few abnormalities in his personality. First, we see that he was a good person and he was a well-educated person. After that, he had some few abnormalities. He has some few abnormalities in his personality. And he was thinking ahead of the time, after centuries ahead, but his officials neither he had integrity nor the maturity to implement his plans. He did not implement many plans to develop their administrative system or their political system. So he did not give an importance to their own region. Those are all about the Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Now let's see some administrative reforms. Before going to that, let's see some taxes which are available on that period. First one is Kharaj, the land taxes on non-Muslims. It is a land taxes related to the non-Muslims. Second one is Ushra. Agricultural taxes on Muslims. Those are all agricultural taxes related to only Muslims. Third one is Zakat. It is related to the property taxes on Muslim subjects. Fourth one is Jizya. It is a religious taxes on Hindus. It was a fixed taxes which the Hindu subjects should give to their ruler. Now let's see some administrative reforms. In that administrative reform, first we see revenue reform. An official record that had all the details of land of the empire was implemented by him. He established a department of agriculture and the uncultivated land were made cultivable. In this area, we see that the government would take the record of official record about their detailed land in their own empire. After that, he was established some departments related to the agriculture, and in this area we see that uncultivable land were made to the cultivable. Various schemes were implemented to provide the financial assistance to the farmer. In this region, in the Tughlaq dynasties, we see that their ruler was given more important to the agriculture, and that cause they has implemented some provincial and some provide the financial assistance to the farmer. But the farmers of Doab had to pay higher land taxes during his time. In the Doab area, we see that high fertile land are there, and that cause they grow good quality of crops, and they got good amount of money. And that cause they means the farmer who are living in the Doab area, they should have to pay high land taxes to the government. Let's see very important point. It is a shifting of his capital. Muhammad bin Tughlaq shifted his capital from Delhi to Devanagiri in central India. First, we see that Muhammad bin Tughlaq was a ruler who shifted his capital into Delhi into Devanagiri. It is situated in central India. There are two main reasons behind this move. When we see that some particular ruler was changes their capital from one place to another place on that time, we see behind this some reasons. So those reasons, let's see which are those. To establish this capital city at the center of the vast empire and protect the capital city from foreign invasions. They means the Tughlaq dynasty's ruler Muhammad bin Tughlaq was wanted to protect their capital city from foreign invasion, foreign attack. Through their plan was a good, the plan was a good and a proper precaution was not taken to implement this. As a result, the innumerable common peoples is suffer severely. When they changes their capital from Delhi to Devanagiri, on that time the common peoples were suffer more. Now let's move on some experiment of a symbolic coins. Gold and silver coins was aesthetically designed. After few days, the copper coins, brass coins also brought into circulation. After some days, we see that the copper and brass coins are circulated in the common people. The maintaining coin was not vast with the government alone. The families who had traditional rights to mint the coins, they were also there, and the coins were minted more than the required number of without the permission of the sultans. The families who are made the coins, they are made lot of coins without the permission of Sultan. As a result, we see that the state treasury was became empty due to the costly administrative experiments. And that time we see the treasury was became empty, and some and severe drought and shifting of the capital city, this process of recollecting the capital back to other measures. It was totally effect to their administrative system, and those causes like shifting of capital and experiment of symbolic coins. Now let's move on Deccan policy. Muhammad bin Tughlaq implemented his administration in the area and conquered by him in the Deccan. Muhammad bin Tughlaq started their administrative system in the area of Deccan. He had conquered the Warangal and capital of Kakatiya, and he also destroyed the Dharasamudra, the capital city of Hoysala. We see that the Muhammad bin Tughlaq was captures many area in the region of our India, like capital of Warangal. Warangal was the capital of Kakatiya, and the Dharasamudra was the capital of Hoysala. Madurai of the South India was conquered by the Jalaluddin. Jalaluddin was named as the governor. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the first Delhi Sultan to establish vast empire in our India. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was established their vast rule in our India, and he was take their rule from our South India also. He was named as the first Delhi Sultan to expand their kingdom in a very vast area. Muhammad bin Tughlaq organized a big army. There was the 27 rebellion in South India during his last 11 years of rule. Those rebellions led to the rise of Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdoms. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was organized, and he was made a big army, and through that army he has taken 27 rebellions in the South India, and last 11 years we see that those rebellions lead rise in the area of Vijayanagara and Bahmani kingdom. Now let's see later Tughlaqs. Firoz Shah Tughlaq, who ascended the throne after Muhammad bin Tughlaq and implemented the numerous people friendly programs. After the Muhammad bin Tughlaq, the another ruler was Firoz Shah Tughlaq, and he was made some policies related to the people friendly, and he was made some programs related to the people friendly, and he waived of Takavi loans for the benefit of their subjects. He has given some loans for the benefit of their own subjects. He has paid the compensation to the victim of Muhammad bin Tughlaq's invasion, and they provide main use for the taxes, and also the taxes were collected for providing the irrigation facility. On that time we see that the Firoz Shah was collected many taxes. In the taxes we see they are collected irrigation facility taxes, and he abolished around the 20 different taxes along with those two. So he was abolished many taxes which are implemented by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and in that different taxes we see is and we see some prominent taxes they are rejected, and he built many cities, mosques, madrasas, dams, irrigation canals, and Jaunpur, Fatehabad, Haisar, Firozpur, and Firozabad were the few important cities built by him. Some important cities are there, and he has given importance to the construction in their own area, and he has constructed many mosques, madrasas, dams for the benefit of irrigation, and for the purpose of irrigation he was made some canals. After that he has made some cities like Jaunpur, Fatehabad, Hisar, Firozpur, and Firozabad. Those are all some important cities which are built by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Jaunpur was the famous learning center. Then the Dharasamudra, and then the Dharmashala were built for the benefit of travelers. He has built the Dharmashala only for the benefit of travelers who are visited to their own kingdom. Those are all about the Tughlaq dynasty. In today's session, we have studies about the Tughlaq dynasty. First, we here sees the establishment of Tughlaq dynasty. After that, we see there are important and prominent kings like Muhammad bin Tughlaq. After that, we have studies about their administrative reforms. In their administrative reforms, we see some taxes related to their own area. After that, some revenue reforms. And after that, we have studies about the shifting of capital. After that, we have studies about the experiment of symbolic coins. After that, we see the Deccan policy. After that, we have studies the later Mughals. Those are all about today's session. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you all like this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel.